Sorry I'm late. Something got a major breakdown at my office for one of my clients today. So I was on the call for a few, another 30 minutes or so. Application breakdown. Thankfully, I found a really good resolution, which was restarting the application, which was locking off the session and resetting the restarting, logging off the sessions and restarting the application that it connects to. I fixed it for basically everyone that I was talking to, which is a good thing. Right now I'm working on a DMG-01 Rebuild.
So you guys can see the action here.
So right now I'm soldering the speaker to this new IPS board here. This is the funny plank variant. There are different other variants as well. There's the Q5 OSD on-screen display variant. Also available for the color and pocket. This is the funny plane version of it. This is the one that I got just to test it out and see how it performs between. Different body versions. See which one is better for the DMG-01, all that good stuff. So I got the speaker work started in. Now it's time to put the screws back in for untap this here. And I did test out the screen here to getting everything in here. Connected and everything. Including that eliminated too. The buttons. Tested all those buttons work without any issues. Right now, just some screwing in. The top of those here. With the new screws and the new shell. Sure if I aligned the power LED correctly. Only one way to find out. So this thing uses 7 screws here. You know, this does not affect the performance of this one. Not sure if I put the correct screws in, but oh well. Okay, so we got the top screen, the top of it done. Hang on, let me zoom out so you guys can see better. So I got the top of this done. There we go. I gotta go clean the top of the screen off.
Now to the next. Now the hard part. Soldering the bay terminals in.
It's gonna be a bit of a pickle here. Just gotta get some flex on here. Reason why for the flex is so we get like a better solder flow. Unfortunately, I have no idea where I put my I could put the base grips in. So I'm just gonna wing it. I'm gonna make sure I put the positive on the positive and the negative on the negative. Let's see here. The negative is on the other side. There you go. Okay, so I did put it in the right spot. Okay. Oops. Apparently it got bent a little bit, so I gotta go and fix it. There, come on. Not the best soldering job, but it works. It is new bigger terminals. Let's go ahead and install it in the back of this here. Thank you.
This way you think something's going to get worse. You always miss. I'm gonna drop a piece somewhere.
I have to get the switch.
I have a spare somewhere. Actually, I have that one box that has all the GMG-01 parts, but I can take a little time switching that off there. Oh, there, excuse me. Check it in here somewhere. Alright, so apparently the toggle switch disappeared on me. Not sure how. It was right in the shell. I don't think I screwed it on top of it accidentally. I mean, that's real possible. No, nothing feels loose in there. Let's look for that piece real quick again. Why? Just dropped it. I think I took it out accidentally. Let's turn it around. Very small piece, that's...
set the timer switch. That turns the system on and off. It also prevents the game cartridge from being pulled out accidentally. The only true way I can actually test this thing is when I put the screws. So in any event, let's go ahead and connect the ribbon cable to the DMG-01. The motherboard is. It's not a big deal. It's like a very important piece of the puzzle. I'm just gonna put these new screws in here. Hold the bottom piece to hold both the pieces in together. Now if I can actually get the pesky screws to align, that'd be great. so now I got it all sorted to a point. I'm gonna insert the paper pick. Oops. Let's go ahead and try out a game. Pokemon Blue. I'll give my hand for a moment. Blue. So let's go ahead and turn it on. Using the rusty trusty screwdriver. Says I don't have the cover for it for some reason. So this is what it looks like. And of course, like I said, I don't have the power switch. Apparently, it somehow that disappeared on me. But let's go ahead and switch the color palettes. Oops, that's brightness. Okay, so hang on, I turn this off here so you guys can see it. Alright, focus, you fuck. Here we go. That's the pixel mode, but unfortunately, did I start the game? Yeah, apparently that doesn't work right. There it is. Rebuilt from the ground up. I have other displays that are arriving again. Not sure if you're able to see that or not, but I think I have to trim a little bit off the shell here. Of course, I can't see the directions here. But other than that, I think it turned out really well. There is a little bit of a bleed right here in the top end, but that's no big deal. It is a clear case. So if it was a red case, I wouldn't have that on there. Oops. So I'm just going to turn it off for now. Get on to the next project, which is replacing the VLB IO card with the promise card and getting the adhesive stuff off of me. think I might know why the screen looks a little bit choppy and both the sides here. One thing I would never ever use on these things, tempered glass anything. So I had to get the tempered glass off of this thing because apparently I didn't get the right screen, so that was my fault. So it looks like I have to trim just a little bit right here on this side. And then Just a hair on this side. I think the display itself is pretty cool. Especially like the inverse mode. Switch between color palettes. It's pretty cool. But unfortunately, so I have to do a little bit of trimming right here, and a little bit of trimming right here. Oh, this guy's just getting by. I have stairs coming in anyways. So that's all for now. Now it's time to focus on this computer. Just gotta go get my arms up here. This barrier cover, which is the regular one. And then get my soldering iron out there. Plug it into the monitor. Which monitor I'm talking about. It's not my the one that I use for office work. I use this one here for my builds. The 386, the 486. The little thing. Go ahead and stop the stream for now. And then start